Delighted to be here today. Have you considered this question recently? What will the world be like in 20 years? The advancement of AI, machine learning, and deep learning are promising to change the way we live and do business today. The question those of us in academia must always ask is, are we preparing our students for what the future will look like? In 2009, I applied to join Elon University. And in my application letter, I wrote that a goal in my career is to help bridge the gap between theory we teach in the classroom and practice. Little did I know where this vision will take me and how it'll help me connect where I come from with where I am today. Growing up in Syria, I was always a dreamer. I watched all the pirated American movies available in the local video store. I had a big dream that one day I'll go to the US to be a bartender. After a lot of hard work and determination, I took all the exams required to come to the US. And I remember as I was leaving my parents in 1998, my father whispered in my ear, "You have the power to change the world. Don't ever forget that." This would be the last time I ever saw my father. He passed away a few months after I arrived in the US, but I never forget what he said to me. I had a tough few years learning a new language, new culture. Through it all, however, my education provided me with avenues to rethink the world around me, to see it in a new light, different from what I grew up with. Now, Mark Zuckerberg, in a global entrepreneurship summit in 2016, said, "The entrepreneurship is not only about creating companies, it's also about creating change." I believe that education can lead the way in creating change that positively impacts many people. In fall 2014, I embarked on a journey to help the business school create a new curriculum for analytics. Excited about the potential this holds for our university, I wanted to learn what other colleges across campus were doing with analytics, and found that we offered analytics programs in computer science, math and statistics, and media analytics. Those programs had the potential for a lot of synergy, and I was confident that if we could all get together, we could learn from each other and provide our students with a new, multidisciplinary, innovative curriculum. I felt that we needed the hub to connect us, enabling us to collaborate, to create classes, research, and to foster relationships we have with community partners. By spring 2015, and as an assistant professor, I walked into Dean Terpelli's office, and I proposed that we start a center for organizational analytics. Now, the dean said it was a good idea, and he was smiling. So before he could continue, I went on to my next thought, which was, let's go around campus and recruit all faculty who are teaching analytics. The dean looked at me and said, let's slow down a little bit and maybe consider sponsorship first. Well, I've never done that before, but I was really excited about the center and what it could bring to our campus. I actually embraced the challenge. Building on existing relationships that the dean had and the university has, we actually partnered with companies who are doing great work with analytics. And as of today, we have 11 partners. Those sponsors give us data, they give us software, and financial support. We also set up an advisory board made up of people who are shaping analytics in their organizations. And now, I thought I was ready to go and invite faculty from across campus, and I did. And as of today, we have 18 faculty members from across campus who are teaching analytics work, and they're working with the center. We also have 17 students working on 7 real projects, solving real problems. They're helping me bridge the gap between what they learn in the class and what they do with our clients. It's amazing the ideas that come through when students from multiple disciplines look at the same problem using their different lenses. While computer science students cannot wait to jump into Python, the statistics students are thinking about measurement theory, and my business students are usually thinking about how does this impact the bottom line? And media analytics students are thinking about how could we present this result in the most meaningful way for the stakeholders? It's amazing. This is what college education should be about. Taking knowledge learned in the classroom and applying it to problems the students really care about. I have seen my students develop the entrepreneurial mindset to create change in the way they approach problems and the way they solve them. Whether it's through their work to improve data processing time for an insurance company from 3 days to 3 minutes, or in their work to analyze IoT data, the Internet of Things data, to help restaurants predict food illness before it actually happens, or in collecting over 72 indicators to build a global snapshot for citizens in North Carolina. The quality of their work is inspiring. Here we are. The quality of their work is inspiring. Excellence acknowledged by all our clients, including Ben Martin. Here, I'm having a little bit of slowness right here. Here we are. Sorry about that. Here we are. The quality of their work is very inspiring. Excellence acknowledged by all our clients, including Ben Martin, the chief officer of advanced analytics at HanesBrand, who has described how impressed he has been by how quickly the students can reach high-quality decisions. Since the center launched in spring 2016, we have established an analytics framework at Elon. And our framework is built on sponsorship, internal engagement, educational events, and consulting and research projects. Using this framework, we have touched more than 1,200 community members, faculty, students, staff, and analytics professionals in our area. And we have hosted over 20 analytics events, events sponsored by Apple, Amazon Web Services, SAS, DataRobot, and many others. My students now tell me when they go for job interviews, they're not just talking about their classroom experiences, but they're also highlighting the positive impact their work has had on our partners. And most importantly, they're also sharing the feedback they have received from executives of those companies or from government leaders in North Carolina. While we cannot know what the future will hold for our students in 2038, but we do know that by preparing them to be problem solvers with a sense of purpose, working together, they will be ready for any challenge they face. And like my dad told me as I left for America, they will be ready and able to change the world and move it forward. Thank you.